Good afternoon, and welcome to the Monarch School and Institute's 2021 Transforming Lives Fundraiser and Luncheon. On behalf of the entire Monarch community, we are so thankful that you are joining us today. My name is Elaine Turner, and I am the proud parent of a Monarch School high school student. I am honored to serve as your mistress of ceremonies today, and I know today's presentation will be extremely unique, but we're living in the days of COVID, so get ready to be excited by this brand new virtual celebration. We are here today to celebrate a very unique school. The Monarch School and Institute is globally recognized and dedicated to providing an innovative, therapeutic education for individuals with neurological differences. In an environment that supports self-determination and empowerment in the greater community. Founded in 1997, Monarch is located in the Spring Branch community and provides an innovative therapeutic education for children, teens, and adults with neurological differences. At Monarch, we are able to serve the whole person with the goal of providing each individual the resources needed to contribute to society in their own unique way. Now, normally we'd be having this glamorous event at a large hotel while we're all mingling around bidding on silent auction items. But due to COVID-19, we're gonna do things a little bit differently this year. But if we've learned anything from this pandemic, it's the importance of technology in our lives. So bear with us as we get through this event, and I think today is gonna be the best virtual celebration that you've seen in a long time. And now let's hear from the incredible Patty Pace, the head of the Monarch School and Institute.
Welcome to our Transforming Lives remote event. Thank you so much for joining us. On behalf of our dedicated board of directors, faculty, our fabulous hostess, Elaine Turner, and the Monarch community, I'm honored to welcome and thank all of you for joining us. I'd like to express gratitude and give a UT shout out to our honorary chairs, Tom Harper, Greg Lott, Mike Loewenberg, Benny Pace, Mike Perrin, and Rob Wilson III. We're so grateful for this Longhorn team and all they've contributed to this important event, supporting our Monarch School and Institute. Thanks, guys.
Today's virtual event serves as Monarch School and Institute's primary fundraiser of the year. So we need your support today to reach these goals, to impact these children, and I'm hoping you're feeling generous today because I know I am. All donations received today benefit general operations and the much needed tuition assistance fund. So please dig down deep into those pockets and know that any donation you could give, big or small, will impact a child or a young adult's life here at the Monarch community. Okay, guys, so let's get started. We are gonna take you on an incredible journey where you're not only gonna get to meet some dynamic young children, teens, and adults, but you're also gonna see our amazing therapists and teachers in action. We thought it'd be a great idea to take you on a journey so that you can see a day in the life of a Monarch student. A typical day for a Monarch student isn't just about an individualized academic plan. It's also about building meaningful connections and relationships with the other Monarch students and staff. So come along with us now as they begin their day at school. See them in their classroom, see them during movement breaks, watch them interact with their friends, and even see them wind down at home.
The day in the life of a Monarch student often begins like any other, rubbing the sleep out of their eyes as they get in a quick breakfast, getting their books in their backpack, ready to be dropped off for an exciting day at school. But a Monarch student's day is often much more unique. The morning routine may be a little different for students with neurological differences, but coming to Monarch means that they will have a day full of personalized learning, academic growth, and therapeutic practice.
This is Kate. She is a transition student with a well-known artistic talent. Kate starts her day in consumer math.
Your income, right, and what your expenses are for the month, and you sit down and you make a plan. You write out a plan of how you're going to spend your money for the month. What, Kate?
You can get like a car payment.
Your cars. That's right. Utilities.
Here they learn about budgeting, banks, how prices work in stores, and other mathematical examples in the real world. This is Coretta, a chrysalis student with an astounding memory. Coretta works on keyboarding, a skill that chrysalis students often practice to help dexterity, focus, and will build a common skill for their future in employment. This is Nate. He is a butterfly student with a reputation for his kind heart. Nate is learning about science and sustainability in our LBC. More specifically about bugs and how they work in the process of compost.
Okay, so that's something. I don't know if anybody would throw those away, but
okay, you're gonna choose one of these. Okay, so you're gonna create an image on a piece of paper, right?
Yeah.
You can use this as a guide.
Okay.
And then you can use the markers or colored pencils, and then you're gonna put it on the cardboard.
His peers work together in illustrative ways to make a presentation about this scientific practice. One of Kate's coaches is preparing her for a very important life skill, how to do an interview. Monarch aims to prepare all their students to work in fields that they can thrive in, and that starts with how to succeed in interviews. She looks like she is doing great. This is Noah. He is a student in the Bridge program with a creative streak. This is where Noah can show off his unique creative expression.
Started, so this is what I recommend. Okay, so hold it really hard here, and instead of going, just pretend like this doesn't move. And hold
it
strong.
Wrapping it around?
Yeah, like that. Okay.
I think we should tape that.
He has made a name for himself creating these unique wire figurines with his teacher, who shows him safely how to work with wire to form these rare characters. Mindfulness class is just one of the many creative ways that Monarch educators give therapeutic experiences to their young learners. They learn the importance of slowing down and the importance of being aware of themselves in the moment. One of the biggest elements of the transition program is the employability program. For Kate, this means working in culinary in the Monarch kitchen. Kate has learned how to cook, clean, organize meals, and work alongside her peers to make healthy zip lunches that Monarch staff and students can order each day. Academics at every level of Monarch programming is important. Coretta practices her math skills through real-life examples so she can see math happening all around her.
Is 3 even?
It's odd.
Oh, 3 is odd. So what number should you do it? And then what's our next group?
2.
What do we have next? 2 is left, and 2 is also.
Monarch offers various classes in coding where the students learn how digital programs and gaming are built, how they run, and eventually how they can be created in visual ways. Nate seems to be getting the hang of it. In writing class, Noah and his classmates are learning the beginnings of how to start a book report.
If we were looking at the Hindenburg, what are some of the things that we would want to put into the Google machine to learn about it?
What the safety protocols
are. Ooh, I like it.
He gives an impressive list of 70s rock bands as subjects that would be interesting enough for such a report.
Digging by me.
Prairie dog is next.
Prairie dog, what do you see? I see a strike.
Group reading not only allows chrysalis students to practice their reading, but to be able to practice associating words and their ability to speak in front of others. Kate is allowed a very special class time here at Monarch in her independent art studio time. Kate has worked to become a very successful painter and has sold countless paintings over the years to individuals, collectors, and companies. Some of her favorite elements in her painting medium is vibrant color and creating textures. In Western geography, Nate and his classmates are learning about the Panama Canal.
Exactly, the cargo ships.
Cargo ships.
Yeah, and look here, Nate, look at your map. Remember, this is where Panama Canal is, right?
Yeah.
They learn about the world map and the history of the many cultures within it. One of the most important elements of a day at Monarch is the freedom of movement. Monarch students often need time to move their bodies and direct their energy. Monarch believes it is so important to allow them to have adequate breaks to do so. Butterfly's movement is paired with a transition program today. It seems that it's a race day.
Go Lorraine!
Go Lorraine! Go Lorraine! Go Lorraine!
Nate's American Sign Language teacher gives him a big hello before he gets on the starting line himself.
Set, go! Go, 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 go! You got it, Nate!
Another example of allowing the students to exert their energy is in their health and fitness class. Today, Noah and his classmates are playing a unique game, like a mix of dodgeball and soccer, but with hands only. In American Sign Language, Nate learns letters, words, expressions, and how to self-regulate during his lessons of this very special language. After a long day of learning at Monarch, Nate is ready to relax and play with his adorable dogs, and then it's off to do homework.
I feel like each year at Monarch, Nate just grows more confident in his abilities. One thing that we know that we can always count on Monarch for is that they're always going to be there to support him, to help him to be more confident in everything he does in the future. And it just gives us so much peace knowing that he's going to be prepared for whatever comes in the next few years and beyond after he's finished at Monarch.
From academics to therapeutics, movement to art, reading to science, the day in the life of a Monarch student is filled with learning, growth, and heart. All while being surrounded by a faculty of incredible teachers, coaches, and mentors that work every day to bring them forth stronger into the world. This has been a day in the life. We can't wait to see what tomorrow brings.
At the Monarch School and Institute, the Chrysalis program is our most intensive program, both educationally and therapeutically. From the layout of the classrooms to the ratio of teacher and student, the Chrysalis program is where we intervene at a very young age to give these kids a chance to thrive as they evolve and grow. Therapeutic educational support is embedded into each classroom to engage students. Our goal is to get these students to understand their needs, strengths, and areas for growth to ultimately let them be able to navigate themselves and learn for their future. Our therapy services team works in various developmental and therapeutic disciplines, such as speech and language pathology, occupational therapy, music therapy, counseling, and psychology. Not only do students with neurological differences struggle to communicate, they often find themselves struggling to also connect with their peers. Once the student develops a relationship with a trusted adult, that person becomes an important mentor and can further facilitate development for that child. We can teach students the skills and behaviors they need to better navigate their lives and their environment. At the Monarch School and Institute, the Bridge and Butterfly programs mirror a traditional high school experience. The kids switch classes several times a day, they have various types of instruction, and they interact with multiple students and teachers throughout their day. For students to move into adulthood employability, we provide typical experiences that allow them to grow, navigate their world, and successfully function in their own lives. Our faculty works with each student to practice relationship skills by providing socials, proms, gymnastics, art groups, music groups, and other extracurricular activities. Our team works closely with each student and the parents to identify the goals for their future, whether it's earning a certificate or a high school diploma, or going to a community college or a four-year university. Monarch discovers what works best for each individual. Monarch Transition Services bridges the gap between school and adult life by offering assistance to adult learners who are making that vulnerable transition to independent living in a supported home environment or a semi-independent apartment. Our adult and adolescent learners live in a home with a professional residential educator who creates individualized plans for each learner. The goal of this program is to create more independence at home and in their community. Monarch's residential faculty are educators who provide teaching and practices in hygiene, physical health and nutrition, meal planning and preparation, household chores, and socialization. Once our adult learners reach a certain level of independence, they will then be recommended for apartment living, where they still will continue to get support from a residential educator. Monarch's employability program is dedicated to providing career opportunities for Monarch graduates and other adults in the local community. Skills are practiced daily through Monarch's Life Academy program, which teaches all sorts of incredible things: culinary, gardening, production, and retail. This progressive approach gives students the ability to seek outside employment and further opportunities in the community. It gives them the most important of all attributes, a sense of self-reliance and self-empowerment. Okay, guys, get excited, because during this presentation, you're going to be able to hear heartfelt stories and experiences from Monarch students, parents, and faculty.
Families have had a lot of struggle. This work isn't easy, and the families really need a sense of hope. So one of the things that we really do is we try to foster an environment of welcoming and warmth and closeness and trust.
I think a lot of them come with the hardship of knowing that they don't, in their other environment, they don't feel like they fit in. They come with their ability to try and hide that and hide pieces of themselves.
We have students that are kind of traumatized from the school system, don't feel comfortable with adults because they think adults essentially don't understand them.
Well, it was a long road to get here to Monarch. I wish we would have gotten here a lot sooner. We spent many years in the public school system, and there it was really an uphill battle. We struggled daily with getting her the support that she needed and really having her feel like she was accepted.
It's important to understand the world that some of our kids here can be in and how difficult education can be while all of that's going on at once. Every student here has their own version of their hardest. In other places, a lot of kids that have potential and it just gets snuffed out.
It hurts to see. It hurts to see these families coming in sometimes with that last hope effort. But I think the key there is the hope.
At Monarch here, you know, we're a multidisciplinary team, but we all tailor all of our jobs to kind of fit the common goal of helping each student succeed.
I think the four core goal model is the most comprehensive that I've seen. It looks at the whole child, the whole individual, at every age and every stage of development. So it can start as young, with the youngest in our Chrysalis program, and follow them through to the Transition Services program.
I've been at Monarch for 20 years, and it started off with me being a student. It helps individuals that really have a hard time with basic life skills like cooking, cleaning, that kind of thing. It kind of helps you get ready for the outside world.
From all the schools I went to, they've had the same curriculum. It's always the same. For me, it's like, I love curriculum. It's just, I love it when it's creative based. Monarch's curriculum is creative based curriculum.
I think it's key for people to understand that Monarch meets the child as an individual.
It's not a one size fits all.
It's not a one size fits all.
You know.
And that, I think, is another one of the greatest contributions that Monarch makes to the community.
I've seen so much growth in Nikon Nikon. Yeah. You are so much more mature. Mm-hmm. You really make an effort to help out anytime that you can.
Well, when I don't understand something, and if I'm having trouble with something, I ask her for help. And what can I say? You can, when something you have hard times with, you can't always do it alone. You have maybe classmates to help you, or even teachers.
Well, I've had a better school experience here than any other school I've been to. Well, when I'm stressed, we find other ways to, like, say when someone's stressed, they find another way to teach to make us not stressed.
You don't have to explain your child. Everybody accepts you for who you are, and it's unconditional.
I think all that support that she gets at Monarch is, it's not something that we had anywhere else. Her relationship with her teachers and the therapeutic coaches, and it goes beyond a typical school relationship for her, and I think it goes both ways.
Well, it helped me to learn, helped me to grow my mind, and helped me to become more independent.
I have seen Danielle be able to trust herself a little more. She second-guessed herself a lot. And these last couple of years, I have seen her be able to produce with little to no help.
I think all of the great goals are simple. I hope for their happiness. I want them to understand that oftentimes what makes things hard for them, that's a fountain for creativity. That's, in its own way, it's valuable. And if they can hone in on that and focus in on that, they can make something beautiful.
I didn't see him actually going to college before. When he was in public schools, I thought, there's no way. Keep up with the rigor, with the classes, with transitions, with all of that. And then him being here, and they've said yes, they've all said yes, he has a chance.
I work in the neurosurgery department here at Baylor College of Medicine. I can't be more grateful to the Monarch School for what they did to me over the years and how they helped me grow. They don't see your disability or your problem is something that needs to be masked, rather something that needs to be shown off to the world, you know, and I think that that's an amazing thing.
All of our learners have such different potentials, different interests, and it's really important to keep in mind that success is measured differently for all of us, and it's not different for individuals with neurological differences.
I think the main thing that makes my job worth it are the learners and the relationships that we develop with the learners. They just bring a smile to my face every day and make me laugh, and there's never a dull moment.
You get to be with the learner, and as you get to know them, you get to bring out what is special about each person, but also fold in the way in which they learn, and then try and find the way that lights them up.
I feel super fortunate and happy to have the opportunity to work at a school where I can provide some level of support to such amazing, unique, inspirational, and just beautiful learners. Every day I come here, I leave full, if that makes any sense at all.
When Nikon was going to middle public school first, and We didn't know there is a better way to do things. And with a good program and professional people, we find out we have a good choice. We pick the right place.
I think that the Monarch School is a very special place for all kids, big and small. A good person needs to respect them all.
You'll find what you're looking for, and maybe it might be this place, and it'll help you understand, learn, and help you with your problems or issues. I think this place made me feel special for me, everybody, and everybody I know.
We got Emma happy. A happy Myanmar.
Listening to the parents talk about their children is a gift because you get to look into their heart. I am devoted to helping every single child that I work with feel like they are part of a world, a greater community. I get to see miracles every day. That's what makes my job worth it. Every day, every moment, miracles.
Financially, I think that, we've been given tuition assistance and it's from the donors. And I don't think we would be here. Sorry. without their help.
We really were at the end of our rope in terms of what are we gonna do? Where are we gonna look?
I remember when we came for the tour, and this one mother, she was with her adult daughter, and she said, we're not looking to enroll, but I wanted my daughter to see the school that changed her brother's life. And I remember thinking, oh my God, this is the place. This is what we've been looking for.
Learners come from all over Houston and surrounding towns. Our team is amazing, our teachers and our therapists, and working with these young individuals, helping them to find themselves, find their confidence, and they're happy. That's really important to all of us.
Whether you're a young adult who's looking for independent living and vocational meaningfulness, or if you're an adolescent that's trying to understand who am I in this world and where am I going in life, or a young child who's figuring out how do I stay in school and how do I learn, Monarch is a place for you. You can find a home here.
At Monarch, we are so grateful for our generous donors. In particular, MD Anderson has recently donated to expand Monarch's incredible commercial kitchen. As part of our Life Academy culinary program, the kitchen serves as a teaching classroom for life skills and as a practice center for employment. This expansion will dramatically increase opportunities for Monarch secondary students and post-grad adults for their skills for employment. Monarch is extremely proud to present the 2021 Honoree Award to Arnold and Itkin. The Arnold and Itkin Foundation, made possible by Kurt and Tara Arnold and Jason and Keisha Itkin. Their generosity ensures that the Monarch School and Institute can continue its vital work through the pandemic and beyond.
I'm Dave Matteson. I'm the chairman of the Board of Trustees at the Monarch School. I'm the parent of Kate Matteson, who's a resident of the residential program at the Monarch School. I'm so delighted to be involved with the school and the great work that they do. Faculty and staff at the Monarch School are innovative and they're tenacious, and they meet the learner where they are. I'm honored to recognize the lawyers and staff at the Arnold and Itkin firm as our honoree for this very unusual Transforming Lives luncheon.
The law firm of Arnold and Itkin has been recognized as one of the best law firms, Tier 1, in Houston by U.S. News and World Report and Best Lawyers for 2021. These well-deserved acknowledgments are not surprising as they go above and beyond whatever it takes to get the job done.
The Arnold and Itkin lawyers are tenacious, fighters. They're committed to their clients, and we at Monarch are delighted that they share that same commitment to excellence and tenacity in helping the Monarch School and Institute. We're very grateful.
Monarch is so fortunate to have Kurt and Tara Arnold and Jason and Keisha Itkin as members of our Monarch community. They have been friends of Monarch for many years, and we are grateful for the generous financial support from the Arnold and Itkin Foundation. It is an honor to recognize them as our 2021 honorees. Thank you, Arnold and Itkin, for always stepping up.
On behalf of Arnold and Itkin, we are very pleased and honored to be the recipients of this year's award from the Monarch School. Although, what I would say is that the real people that should be honored are the parents and the kids at the Monarch School. If you're watching this today, I mean, obviously you know about some of the great things the Monarch School does, but it really is a treasure to the Houston community.
You know, I first learned about the Monarch School through my friend Dave Matteson. He used to talk to Jason and I about it all the time and talk about how a special place it was. And one day he said to me, he said, you know, y'all really ought to go. I said, let's go. I was so impressed by what I saw at the school, the amazing faculty, the resources, the commitment, the kids. Ultimately, you know, Jason and I drove home that day and I said, we got to get the girls out. And so the next week we all went out, the four of us, and Keisha and Tara were also blown away. And when we came home, we all agreed that we needed to help.
As a mom, you want to do the very best for your child. Every one of us do. You look at them and you think, I want to put them in the best situation to thrive, to achieve the best that they can be. And so it's heartbreaking for any parent to have their child in an academic situation or environment that really isn't tailored to their needs and helping them thrive.
I know firsthand, Keisha and I know firsthand, we've looked actually at schools like the Monarch School across the country. I have a cousin with a profound neurological disease, and when we tried to find a place for him, it was hard. There weren't places that had the level of care, the level of commitment, the level of compassion that the Monarch School provides. And when we got to see the Monarch School, we were blown away that there was such a resource here for all Houstonians.
When we got presented with the opportunity to help the Monarch School, we jumped at it. And you know, once we got to know some of the faculty, know the community through fundraisers or otherwise, I was surprised about how many friends I have that have been touched by the Monarch School and all of the things that the Monarch School does for obviously the broader community and the kids. I know COVID has been hard on everybody, and jobs have been affected, and salaries have been reduced, and illness and otherwise. And it's been tough to fundraise in this environment, but the needs of the Monarch School have never been greater, and the needs of the Monarch community have never been greater. And because of that, I ask that you dig deep, step forward, and help enable the Monarch School continue its mission, continue to help kids, because they cannot do it without the continued fundraising of their broader community.
It doesn't matter if it's a pandemic year, it doesn't matter if it's a year when the economy is doing great, those needs are always there. There is nothing more important than helping children, and especially children who have neurological needs, or children who have neurological impairments. And so what we would ask you to do this year is to help as much as you can, because every dollar that goes to the Monarch School goes to help a child. Goes to help a child achieve their full potential, live a happy life, a healthy life. And there is nothing more important, nothing that's more important than helping children.
Thank you again to the Monarch School for this award. We are thrilled to join the co-chairs of the University of Texas Austin as supporters, and we invite you to join us today in support of this virtual event and fundraiser for the Monarch School.
Thank you guys so much for watching today. And I cannot tell you how much it means to the Monarch community to have your time and attention to talk about what we do as a school and what we provide this vulnerable population. Now more than ever before, during this really hard time of COVID-19, we need your support. There's nothing more important than investing in a community that we know can provide and produce and contribute to our society. So please give it so much thought today and think about donating to Monarch, because I'm telling you, you won't regret it. These souls deserve so much, and we are so honored to serve them here at the Monarch School and Institute.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.